I'm guessing I present the fruit to the different things. I don't know. I'm only guessing here. Go up to the stairway. Okay.
The mask wasn't hungry. It seemed rather happy.
Oh, okay. Then I don't think you actually need food then. All right. Main hall. Well, we have progressed probably nothing further. Honestly. I feel like we need those masks, but I don't know what sort of thing we need to get it down. You know, I wonder if it's the hairpin that we need. But we need something that either we have or we don't have to actually get it from the two people. Because I think that's the hairpin.
What's that supposed to be? A Marashu Nyoki Shibuya accessory?
A sweet little Pokemon?
Or a weapon to combat the dark forces? Shing! Shing!
Uh-uh.
What else should we do with it? What have you got now? I hope it's a weapon for the battle against... But that's a real detonator! And it's live! You have to defuse it, Suka! Hurry!
But with what?
With the power of love!
What? Are you... Wait! I know!
Phew, that was close.
We'll snitch to Mother Superior.
Exactly. This time you really went too far, Lily. What on earth are you thinking? You're even crazier than I thought.
Totally un-gumbo.
Don't just stand there. Get that bomb away from us. Take it somewhere where it can't do any damage.
A bomb-proof place.
A fireproof drum or something like that?
Have I acquired the hairpin? I have. Wait. What do I say? I have the hairpin. I think I'm gonna go to the well then. Well then. We will go to the well, I believe. Detonator with a hairpin. That does not impress him. A fuse with a hairpin in it? People are really hard to impress here. Okay then. Pungent time or... What in the world do I... I'm gonna try the chapel. And by the way, that screeching scared the living crap out of me, so...
What's that for? If you really want to help, then decipher the symbols on the stone slabs. I think I'm drilling in the wrong spot. Don't you know anyone who's good at history?
I do. I have a guy. I think I have to go to the stove. I think I'm not even quite sure.
It was the perfect place to get rid of the detonator.
What's that? What do you have there?
Lily could finally use the hairpin.
Does it have to blink like that?
Lily closed the door again to keep Memphis's hiding place safe.
Oh, Lily? Oh my god. Lily. No.
Something seemed to be wrong with Lily's ears today. She kept hearing all these sounds.
Oh my god. So we have some... Okay. Oh my god. Did we actually just blow a guy up? Ew. Yeah. Oh my god. I'm gonna use this hairpin to get things. I'm not giving the hairpin back, quite frankly.
This was certainly not the ideal tool to loosen the screw, and as long as Lily didn't have a compelling reason, she didn't have to take the risk.
No.
Perfect. The hairpin fit exactly into the holes.
Oh. I'm gonna get all these masks. Holy crap, okay. This is why I need the hairpin. I have masks. Okay. As to what I need to do with them, I do not... Wait. No, put this on. I want to put this on to scare the guy at the well. Shawnee or whatever his name is.
Shawnee didn't seem to be interested. Lily had...
You know what? I just put it back.
Ooh, look who's coming to- If it is, you better spoil.
I literally blew a guy.
If you're trying to impress me, you'll have to work a little harder. You're too scared to- And that means-
You know what? I'm gonna go to the pond, and I'm probably gonna show you your dead friend. He probably wasn't even your friend, to be honest. Oh. Can I take you now? Or?
Lily got along great with- That's-
Nope.
The stove was black and empty, just like the mirror that always appeared in Lily's dreams.
We literally killed a guy. Holy crap. Dang. I cannot take a sample of what I have done. I don't know. Wait. Do we gotta go get that arm thing or whatever? Show him or... What? No, go back.
This ball of wool was a symbol of friendship. Lily wanted it to stay in the treasure chest for eternity.
Never mind. What do I do to impress the guy, man? Excuse me. I'm just tired. The window. I gotta do something to get that recipe. I really don't know. I guess go to the convent or something. I don't know.
The guinea pig was probably tired. It was completely unimpressed by Lily's things.
Oh, okay. Wait. No?
Shawnee didn't seem to be. Lily had to.
Deadly nightshade?
Shawnee didn't seem. Lily had.
Okay. I do not know how to impress you by being tough. I do not. You know, first, I think we need. Well, I'm glitching out on me again. Well, we have masks. Fruit. I don't know what else we need. As far as things go, really. And I really don't know. Checking that one lady to hurry up, and I need like a pedestal or something to put the guinea pig on.
Capu was the nicest guy at the convent school. Lily liked him so much that she had even named her cockroach after him. That reminded her that she'd been meaning to punch air holes in the box for weeks.
Keep your things to yourself. I'm sure you worked very hard for them.
Aww. I don't know what to do. What, maybe start putting things on a shelf or something? I don't know, I think we only have got two of the items, right? I don't know.
Hmm? What? Do we know each other?
Uh-huh.
What's the matter, sweetheart? Did you forget your question? Here's a small tip. Just try to remember the three E's. The first E stands for emotion. It tells me whether I was sad, happy, or angry in that situation. The second E stands for engagement. It reminds me of whether I overcame the situation with strength, heroic courage, or sleepiness. The third E stands for eating. To remember, I have to know which.
Okay, so, well, apparently we need those heads, which means we need to get the one girl's butt moving on. We don't have a pedestal, though, so I'm not finding one. On a pedestal to put, what? That is the old man? Yes. Heavy mask, apple. I have a motif, but it's not on a pedestal. need you guys.
Stop that! I need that as a...
She had to be the happiest child in the world.
Don't distract me. Unless you have an idea what I can embroider next. I need the perfect motif. An animal that embodies important values.
Guinea pig?
The guinea pig had bathed long enough.
It was quite...
What's that supposed to be? An animal motif?
Uh-huh.
No animal motif looks like that. Animal motifs are always on a pedestal. Don't you know anything?
Well, I need to go find pedestal then. Excuse me. I do not know where to find such pedestal, but I shall look.
Lily had always liked the large painting in the main hall. It showed a dining table after a big meal, with a man in the center who had found the last cookie. Lily giggled at the thought that he would eat it all by himself, no matter how much the others begged.
We need a pedestal thing, but I don't know where to get the... Wait, I don't know. So, go check... The ladies' room. The mother, the scary mother.
There seemed to be some kind of bracket up on the wall. But Lily couldn't continue without more light.
Do I have any lighting? I do not have any sort of lighting source here.
Lily had heard rumors that disobedient children were hung from this hook. Otherwise, Mother Superior used it to hang her tea kettle over the fire. At night, Mother Superior, but at this time of day, Mother Superior usually made her tea over the fire of the outside fireplace.
Wait. Can I take this thing and use it? Okay.
Lily thought this idea was delightful. The guinea pig was bound to make a huge impression as an animal role model.
Oh my god, it's on a pedestal now. Wow, that took me for her to realize it. Okay. Well, at least I went to the right one, I guess. Present the pedestal guinea pig. Lost where the mouse was on the screen. Okay. Down to the main hall. Then go present that as the motif. And have her finish it, and then finally get the key, and then progress more in the game. Which will help. Now that I realize I'm kind of not that good at playing video games sometimes. Ugh. It's gonna be so much editing to cut down how much time I'm actually recording. Okay, ma'am, I have a thing for you.
Huh, at least this is a regular animal motif. But do you think it also conveys really important values?
Of course it did. Guinea pigs were cute and small, but always cheerful. Lily always tried to follow their example.
Uh-huh. Well, if you say so. Come back in a few minutes. If you don't bother me, I won't take long.
Well, she is working on it. So I will go and report. But we actually have the eagle one. Okay. Alright. We do not actually have the eagle animal motif, but I keep on losing the mouse here. Into the cafeteria. Report to her.
Is that really so hard to understand? Feed the cat.
Yeah, well, I have marbles and a jar of alcohol. I will get the thing up. I will go check on it now. I totally wrecked up that stove with that detonator, though. I so messed it up. I messed that up. Really badly. Good kind of badly, though, I think. Into the classroom. Feed the cat? Yeah, I have nothing to feed the cat. Oh my god, am I really gonna feed it? Aha. Thank you. I will get to you soon, things. Time to go report and go give that to Mother Superior. Getting closer, progressing in the story. It's very interesting, weird story. Very, very, very soon. I have thing for you. Never mind.
Birgit has finally finished the new banner, but what's that? A small, dirty guinea pig? Birgit didn't really make this, did she?
Uh-huh.
That can't be true. Can I not rely on anyone here? Just you wait. She'll get what's coming to her.
Oh my god, what are you gonna do? Oh my god, I'm a little scared for her.
The banner was a disgrace.
Get rid of it!
I want to put it back up, though. Oh. I cannot take the coming day or the salt and pepper shakers. Okay. I think the lunch lady might be coming down with a sickness. I will not recommend eating her food. Let's go see what happened to her. Probably gonna regret this. By the way, a lot of this music is kind of really scary when you don't expect this all at once. She's probably gonna drop the key, and then I'm gonna use that, and then I'm gonna finish helping that, and then I'm gonna go capture Garrett.
I can't even tell you how disappointed I am in you, Birgit. This is the worst job I've seen in my entire career.
But
don't talk back. You are bad. I will probably have to strip you of all your awards, prizes, and Girl Scout badges. You no longer deserve any of them.
But I only did what?
Hogwash! Do you really wish to contradict me? I can't believe how low you've sunk, Birgit. A guinea pig? It's unbelievable! Your work is an insult to the entire convent. Get rid of it!
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to...
Your whining won't make up for your failures. Just in case you decide not to waste my time with your ineptitude anymore. Here is a motif that's worth immortalizing on a banner. The puma. Strong, precise, dignified. A symbol of self-control.
Stop that! I need that as a tech.
Okay. Well, I finished gathering my things to help. Bye. I can now help with the chapel thing. This is a good thing. This is progress. The animal that dealt with that river, maybe? I think that honestly is the thing, but back.
Hmm? What? Do we know each other?
Uh-huh.
What's the matter, sweetheart? Did you forget your question? Here's a small tip. Just try to remember the three E's. The first E stands for emotion. It tells the second rem. The third to rem. Wait. Wasn't I just about to tell you something? Fortunately, I created a memory aid just now. Let's. On that day, I was particularly happy. We had just laid the stone slabs in the chapel when the Templar Knights returned from a secret meeting. They checked the stability and praised my strength. Then they tossed an apple at me. No, wait. That's not how it was. This story doesn't make someone's been messing with.
Okay, let me take you. I honestly have no idea what this
is. Hmm? Do we?
Uh-huh.
What's the matter, sweetheart? Did you forget your question? Here's a small tip. The first. The third to rem.
Not the right one. Not that one.
Wait. Wasn't I just about to tell you something? Fortunately, Now, let's see. On that day, I was particularly happy. We had just laid the stone slabs in the chapel when the Templar Knights returned from a secret meeting. They examined my work and praised me for doing a heroic job. We ate a banana together. No, wait. That's not how it was. This story doesn't make any sense. Someone's been messing with my memory.
Coconut.
Hmm? What? Do we know?
Uh-huh.
Wait. Wasn't I just for now? Let's. On that day, I was particularly happy. We had just laid the stone slabs in the chapel when the Templar Knights returned from a secret meeting. They examined my work and praised me for doing a heroic job. Then they gave me a coconut. No, wait. This someone?
The special day that Nats helped me, I was neither happy about an apple nor furious about a banana. Also was not sad about a banana nor happy about a coconut. So you're angry about a coconut, I guess. I don't know.
Hmm? What? Do we know each other? For now, on that day, I was particularly happy. We had just laid the stone slabs in the chapel when the Templar Knights returned from a secret meeting. They examined my work and praised me for doing a heroic job. Then they gave me a coconut.
No, wait. That's not how it was. This story does someone's...
So you were happy because you laid down the last slab. Then they praised you for a thing...
It reminded Lily of the time when she stole the fruit from the cafeteria.
Okay. Why do I not have a pork? Never mind. Don't know.
Hmm? What? Do we know each other? Happy? We had just laid the stone slabs in the chapel when the Templar Knights returned from a secret meeting. First, they had to wake me because I was very sleepy. Then they gave me a coconut.
Apple? I think.
Hmm? What? Do we know each other? Wait. Wasn't I just about to tell you some fortune now on that day? Happy? We had just laid the stone slabs in the chapel when the Templar Knights returned from a secret meeting. First, they had to wake me because I was very sleepy. Then they tossed an apple at me.
I have absolutely no idea.
The fact that she wasn't getting anywhere made her sad.
What? Do we know each other?
Uh-huh.
Fortunately, I create. Now, let's see. On that day, I was particularly angry.
Okay, I guess we'll try those. Okay.
Hmm? What? Do we know each other?
Uh-huh.
Wait. Wasn't I just about to tell you something? Fortunately, I created a memory aid just for this anecdote. Ah, exactly. Now I remember. On that day, I was particularly angry. We had just laid the stone slabs in the chapel when the Templar Knights returned from a secret meeting. They examined my work and praised me for doing a heroic job. Then they gave me a coconut. It was one of the greatest days of my life. Here, I even still have the book in which I wrote everything down, including the meaning of the secret Templar symbols on the stone slabs. And now please leave me alone. All this reminds me too much of how I once helped a little girl uncover the mystery of the secret crypt below the chapel. One day, I really have to tell you that story.
I have an old book. I'm gonna go to the chapel.